6 minutes now to 11 o'clock, 0500 909 693. Dragos Den was on the BBC tonight, BBC Two, of course. There was a bog in a bag.
Hello, my name's Darren Madison.
And my name's Helen Wright.
We are equal partners in polka dot pantomimes. We hope you enjoy our pitch. Oh, it's the girl of my
dreams. This is a passion of yours as much as anything. And I've always said, follow your passion, because actually you don't mind working those extra hours. But as an outside investor, I'm not necessarily wanting to spend all those hours the way you do for little return. So I'm unfortunately not going to invest today, and I'm out.
So today I am here to find that money, to get that cash that is going to drive my business forward into the next few years. And so I try to do this.
So that's a sense of tonight's programme. What we want to concentrate on is the bog in the bag, the entrepreneur behind it, Kate Castle. Hello to you, Kate. Hello, Kate.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm feeling good, thanks.
Good stuff. I was impressed with you tonight. Really was. You kept your cool in front of those dragons, and it's when the likes of Duncan says, I'm out, and you just feel like slapping them. I did.
Yeah, thanks for that. Yeah, I definitely felt like slapping him. It was a really, really stressful experience to be up there, and Duncan gave me quite a hard time. So, yeah, I knew he was going to be out really from as soon as I was doing my pitch. Duncan's face said everything, so it was no surprise when he said those words to me.
And then when Peter said to you, you've got nothing more than a chair with a hole in it.
Yeah, you know, actually, when Peter said that, you know, we were having a bit of a joke about it. And, you know, Peter was quite complimentary on my pitch and also about the product. But at the end of the day, I don't think it was for him. But luckily, it was for some of the other dragons.
Why don't you explain to us, it's probably good that you do at the top here, what your product actually is?
Yeah, well, basically, it's a portable toilet. It's really lightweight, weighs less than a kilo. It comes in a bag. It folds out much as a camping stool would, but it also has a cover. So when you remove the cover, there's a hole, and within the hole you place one of the specially designed degradable bags. This completely covers the seat, so it's very hygienic, and within each bag's a highly absorbent pad. You then obviously sit down, go to the toilet, and once you've finished, you remove the bag, tie the top, which completely seals it, and then you dispose of it. So it's absolutely completely designed for camping, festivals, and outdoor use.
How many years have you been working on this?
To be honest, I was back kind of camping in Dorset about 3 years ago now, and kind of lying awake at night and desperate for the toilet, and I didn't want to kind of trek across a dark campsite, and I thought, you know, there had to be a better option than kind of your bulky chemical-based toilets. So I kind of had a bit of this brainwave of, you know, designing the ultimate portable toilet. And it was almost kind of a hobby at the start. And then, you know, I got more and more serious about it. And it took me nearly 2 years to get to market. And there was a lot of patent applications, product design.
And for us novices, actually applying for a patent, is it complicated? Is it expensive?
Yeah, definitely. Yes, to kind of both those questions.
What kind of money, Kate?
You know, it's difficult to kind of put an amount of money on getting a patent. We're still actually, you know, I'm probably 2 years down the patent process, and we're still only pending, and many thousand pounds later. But, you know, it's just really, really complicated. But, you know, you start off on this process and you don't really know where you're going, and you just go with it. But I was quite lucky, because what I managed to do was move quite quickly to market. So by the time I was selling my product, I was making enough money to kind of pump that back into patent applications and marketing. So we had some sales in there too to bring money back into the business.
It just strikes me. It struck me tonight when I was watching you, and I might have got this completely wrong, but to give away 30% of your business for, what did you get, 50 grand?
Yeah, that's right.
50 grand's a lot of money, but you could presumably have borrowed that. Now, it strikes me what you were really after was the contacts and the expertise of the dragon more than the money.
Yeah, undoubtedly. I think, you know, to get a product to market, you know, I could have borrowed, begged, you know, stolen, you know, I would have got that money. If I need that money, I would have found that money. But Dragon's Den gives you this amazing opportunity to pitch your product to five of the most important people in this country that have so much power. But not only that, you know, this... It's also a huge ad, isn't it?
It's a huge PR
opportunity.
I was surprised, actually, at the BBC keeping it in tonight, but I noticed Theo... And he managed to product place one of his own products tonight as well. He mentioned, oh, yeah, he said, you know, I have a product, and he mentioned the name of the product. And I thought to myself, well, you know, for those people that are doing this, you know, like yourselves, what a huge ad that this is. For the, what is it, 5 million people?
Yeah, it's an amazing number of people. And, you know, one of the most amazing things about tonight was not only being incredibly relieved to watch myself and not... think I didn't come across too badly, but also to sit there with my BlackBerry and hear it go bing, 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 bing as my orders came in. And, you know, and that's what it's all about. At the end of the day, I have a business and I want to do the best for my business.
So hold on a minute. Now, I'm really into this. Tonight, you got orders because you're on telly.
Yeah.
Through the website.
Yeah. The orders are coming in, you know. My phone's on silent at the moment, but hopefully it's still binging away in my bag.
That's exciting. Significant numbers?
Yeah, significant numbers. Dragon's Den is an amazing platform for your business, and that's what's so exciting about it. And I'm, you know, and having Theo on board and his contacts is really exciting, but also, you know, you should never underestimate the power of being on telly in front of millions of people.
What's your dream?
My dream is to take this product to the international market, but to also do other products. And, you know, this is a platform really for me and my product and my business. And, you know, it's very, very exciting times. And I know Theo's got, lots of great ideas about where he wants to see us in the future. And
so has he spoken to you much since?
Yeah, you know, Theo's, you know, he's been doing it for a long time. He's got a really professional setup. I work very closely with his team, but also, you know, Theo's there. You know, I've got his email address. You know, I can contact him for kind of advice.
He came into the Five Live studio in London. I think it was New Year's Eve or Children Need Night, actually. I really liked him. I just thought there's a, I don't know if he is or not, but his impression on me, he certainly had made an impression on me, and I thought he was a decent bloke.
Theo's great. Theo's, as you see him on the telly, he's fun, he's easygoing, no nonsense. Obviously, he's been in business.
We wish you the best of luck, kid.